Color grading C-Log footage is actually much easier than you think. And with a tiny bit of knowledge, you'll be able to go from this to this in about 1 minute. Today, I'll show you how to do it without any special plugins or LUTs. I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel. Conversion LUTs are great when they work, but what do you do when they fail? And they will fail. This technique I'm using in this video will work in any editor that has color correction tools. I did this exact same walkthrough in DaVinci Resolve and Adobe Premiere. You can find those links in the description below. In this video, we'll talk about how to set the exposure and contrast properly in log footage, how to easily white balance with and without a color chart using the waveform, how to correct skin tone issues using the vectorscope, how to check to make sure that the skin tone is set between 40 and 70 IRE and exposed properly, how to set the presets to use on all your footage, and how you'll never have to ask for help again once you've practiced these steps. Full disclosure, I am not a colorist, but for most of my client work, I will gladly hire pros to be as precise as possible to grade the footage. However, for smaller projects and my own personal work, I've learned these steps required to quickly get from log footage to the base grade without using LUTs or expensive plugins. So this isn't the be-all and end-all for color correcting C-log footage, or any log footage for that matter. There are many ways to do the same thing, but it's a method I found that works really well to rough in a base grade and add some personality to it after. So let me ask this question. Why do we shoot log in the first place? It's to ensure that the camera captures the most amount of detail in any scene, the darkest dark and the brightest bright. Rec 709 is designed to output between 7 and 9 stops of dynamic range, and it's mostly a display standard. Log helps expand that distance to 12 to 16 stops depending on the camera. Rec 709 color space looks pleasant. Log footage does not. So then we have to bring back the information to a pleasant look. But now we can choose if we want the brighter end, the darker end, or a nice mix of both. As I go through this method, I will try to cut it down to only the essential things you'll need to know to correct and then grade your footage. All these steps assume that your footage is exposed mostly correctly and is within the right white balance. Check out this video where I talk about correctly exposing your EOS R for C-log footage. And since you're here, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if this video helps you out. Quick terminology recap we'll be talking about in this video: color correction and color grading. Color correction is when you fix color issues, color space, color temperature, the white balance, or skin tones in the video. Color grading is adding color for creative purposes, to convey meaning, mood, location, time of day, themes, character associations. It's really powerful stuff psychologically. If you have a color chart, this will help setting up your own LUTs or correcting for any location. But don't worry, I'll show you how to correct even without a color chart. All a LUT does is tonally remap colors from one place to another. This value should be this, and that value should be that. And it's all based on the log footage you start with. That is why different LUTs don't work with different log footage. And it's why creative LUTs never work without normalizing your footage first. They all assume the footage is starting from a certain color space, like Rec 709, which is the most common. But we won't be talking about the creative grading much in this video. This video is how to get your log footage to a starting point by normalizing it. The creative decisions you make on how you want your footage to look after that, that is up to you. That's where you get to play and have fun. If you like it and you think it looks good, go for it. There really are no rules. To be clear, there isn't
one LUT to rule them all.
Unless your footage is perfectly exposed with 100% perfect white balance, expect to do a bit of tweaking, either the color tint or the luma. Though there are some simple truths that do work as a starting point, and today we'll cover that workflow. And if you have a color chart up, I know what you're thinking. But Rafael, I don't have a color chart, so this isn't gonna work for me. And you would be wrong, random citizen. I am going to show you how to do it without color charts and even without any skin tone in the shot. So just give me a second. We're gonna start with the color chart first because this is the best way to get precise colors. Open up the waveform monitor. Let's make it a little bit bigger. This represents the luminance values across the image from left to right. The bottom is black and top is full white. So from left to right, you can actually see where all the hot spots are, where all the brightness happens. Here are all the colors on the color chart, the white, gray, and black right here. So what we want to do with these three stripes right here, we want to bring the white as close to the top as we can. We want to bring the middle gray right into the middle, and we want to bring the black as close as we can to the bottom without touching it. I like bringing the black to about 5 or 10% and the white to about 90, 95%, and then adjust from there. So once you have your image open and waveform is up,
choose Waveform, Luma, and IRE. We're gonna add some color wheels to this image. We're gonna drop the blacks down and bring the highlights up to near 100. That looks pretty good. We want to add saturation over here. Then we want to crop the image just to the white, gray, and black. And this is where you can bump up the midtones just a bit. You can go to RGB parade. And this is where you want to check to make sure that your whites are white and your grays are gray. So there's definitely a little bit of red in the image in the highlights. So you want to move away from the red and into the green and the blue until they're roughly lined up. And then you want to make sure that the midtones are in the same place. So there's a little bit of blue. So you want to add some red just ever so slight. And then you can check to make sure that your shadows are in a good place. So that feels pretty good. I'm going to bring the IRE back to 70. Now I'm going to double check the skin tone. So I'm going to just make sure that I trim and only have the skin tone. Go into the vector scope and we can see that it is leaning towards yellow. We want to bring in some red and magenta. Overall, especially to the highlights, and just notch that over ever so slightly. That looks good. I'm gonna open that up. And then we want to add some curves to add some contrast to the overall image. Just log again, and it is very flat and needs to add some contrast and saturation. That is your correction. This is the before, this is after. And then you can save your preset, the colors, save it to studio, save it to the category that you want, click save, and we'll go to an image that I know was shot in the same lighting scenario. Go into settings and add studio, drop it in, and then your colors are there. Now, because this feels a little bit bright, I'm gonna double check to make sure that the skin tone, I'm gonna select the brightest part, and I'm gonna go to the waveform again and just go to Luma and make sure that the skin tones are between 40% and 70%. So I can drop down the overall brightness. And this as a base correction, you can definitely work with this. And then, and this is where you can start adding your teal and orange overall to the image. You want to add some teal and then boost up the saturation and add some orange. And subtlety is the key. So again, before, after, base correction, teal and orange. Simple. So let's do another shot right from scratch. I'm gonna add in some color wheels. I'm gonna drop down the shadows, bring them all the way down. This waveform monitor shows the luminance values of every single pixel in the image. I know that this shirt should be blacks, but not totally black. So around 10% looks good. And then these doors should be blown out a little bit. So I'm gonna bump that up. And her face is right here, represented by this. So I don't want to go above 70, so that feels pretty good. Want to add some overall saturation, not too much. Then I want to add some contrast overall. Again, knowing that the skin tone for lighter complexion should be around 70, no higher. You don't want to go too high. But now we're just going to double check the skin tones to make sure that they are what they need to be. So I'm going to go over the cheek and try to make sure you don't get the eye or the lips, because that starts to add in different colors and it will mess up your vectorscope. So then go to the vectorscope, and that looks pretty good already. And definitely exposing for the right color temperature when you're filming is going to help you with these color corrections down the line, but you can tweak it just a bit. So there you go. So this is straight log, and this is the corrected image. And from here, you can start adding your creative LUTs or doing any kind of color correction. So let's just do the popular orange and teal. We're just gonna add another color wheels. We're gonna add some teal to the shadows, and we're gonna add a little bit of orange overall. We're just gonna double check the skin tone to make sure that it's still in a nice place. Overall, just add a little bit of saturation, and you just want to let your skin tone stay closer to the center of the vectorscope. Because if you add in too much saturation, let's see what happens, okay? So I want to keep it right around there. So I'm going to turn off that, but let's say we wanted to add a lot of saturation. Becomes a little bit nutty. So it really comes down to your creative choices and what you feel looks good and what you want it to look like. So I definitely like to stay closer to natural. This is proper exposure and color correction. This is a little bit of teal and orange. So let's do another shot which has no skin tone. So I'm gonna add color wheels. I'm gonna open up my waveform monitor and drop down the shadows. I'm gonna boost up the highlights. And again, because I know that these boots should be black, but there's gonna be a lot of reflection that's coming in from A, the warm sun, and B, the reflection of the ground. So this already feels like it should look like that, but let's add in a little bit of coolness overall. So I'm just gonna crop so I can see just the black boots. Go to RGB parade, and we want to make sure that these all roughly line up. So I want to add some blue into the shadows. Not too much, because I know it's supposed to be a warmer shot. So when you look at it, so again, this is the before, this is the after. Let's do one more shot. Again, starting from scratch, no LUTs, no FUTs. We're gonna add some wheels. Drop down the shadows. The highlights are already kind of pretty good. We're gonna add some saturation overall. Add some curves to bring back some of that contrast. Going to double check the skin tones to make sure that they're exposed properly and of the right color. So right now everything feels a bit too bright, so I can just drop that down. And then I want to check to make sure that the skin tones are the correct color, and they look like they need a little bit of red and magenta. Just bring it over that skin tone line indicator. So then when we pop back out, this is the before and after. And you can save these presets. So once I have a base color correction, that's when I add in sharpness. Usually leave it at the default 2.5%. This is just adding back some of the sharpness that was lost when filming in C-Log. But there are some shots that I feel that definitely benefit from pushing a little bit more, or some that don't need it at all. Especially if you want to keep any blemishes or skin issues off, this is where you don't want sharpness in. But there are some cases where you do want to make it a little bit punchier. But I tend to leave it at the default 2.5, which is what the camera would have done naturally unless you bring it down. That's why I bring down the sharpness. But it allows me for those situations where I want to get rid of it completely and soften the image or boost it up. I have that control. I like that. And especially if I built it into the preset, I can just quickly then turn it off. The other thing that I do add for a lot of my other shots is a vignette. I drop it in. make sure that it is focused in around where I want the audience to look. So with it off, with it on, and you just want to make sure that it's not too dark. Everything is about subtlety with color grading and color correction. And the vignette definitely helps get rid of some of the extra noise that builds up in the darkness in EOS R shots. But it helps draw the attention. All these lines are leading here. The focus, the brightest thing in the image is my face or the R, which is all in around here. This is where I want the audience to be looking. So before C-Log and then the final grade. So let me know what you guys think of this process. It is simple. You don't need LUTs. You don't need expensive plugins. You don't even need the color chart that I'm using. I recommend it. I think it's great. And there's a lot of coloring tools that work really well, but you don't need them. If you have any of these editing software, you're going to be able to achieve really good looks with all the footage that you have. Knowing how to correct when a LUT fails, you'll be able to correct your images properly. If you have a computer, all you need is DaVinci Resolve, which is the industry standard and probably one of the most powerful tools out there to use, and it is free. I personally like using Final Cut Pro. I bought it in 2011, have only paid once for it, and it has gotten better over time. I find that it is the quickest tool from in to out with any personal project that I have. So again, before and after. There are many other things you can do, but I just wanted to show how to color correct for C-Log footage from the Canon EOS R and C-Log 3 footage from the C200.
So let's recap. Use the waveform monitor, drop the shadows to about 5%, bring the highlights to about 95%, add a little contrast, boost the saturation using the vector scope, check to make sure your skin tones are on the skin tone indicator, use the luma value between 40 to 70 for skin, add your creative grade that fits your story and mood, sharpen the image to what feels right for you, add a vignette to help focus on the important thing in the scene, save your preset or LUT, apply the grade to the rest of your footage, and you are done. If you do find a LUT that works for you and it converts and corrects your log footage correctly, use it. It'll save you a lot of time. I made this video as a guide for when your LUTs don't work or you get tired of a particular look and you want to create your own, and for you to be able to color correct your C-Log footage in any scenario. Let me know if you guys have any tips or tricks to color grade your C-Log footage. Also, I would love to see how you guys use these techniques to color grade your own C-Log footage. As always, thanks for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe if it helped you out. I'm Rafael. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.